credible or not. And we are saying it is.
And there's an objective basis for that. Congress cannot, has to proclaim Aquino
based
and
on,
even the Vice President based on a mathematical consistency.
Yes. Now
that's objective. Mm. They cannot so, take it back or deny that.
That's what's going to happen. And COMELEC will say, and I believe those members of the so-called presidential, vice presidential, electoral commission, which is members of Congress meeting together, for the proclamation, we go ahead and proclaim.
Right.
But there will be isolated cases like the ones in your province, and they will be encouraged to file complaint. Now, when those complaints are going to be resolved, don't ask me, because complaints in this country has been forever.
But it's interesting what Marisa's brought out in her province alone. But this is not empirical data, but she's saying, how is it possible that a person who's unknown in Leyte has become a front runner, and a candidate who's never really visited has become the front runner? Very much so, the results of accurate counting when fraud was already committed before the actual electronic voting. In this case, vote buying. Mm. And then three, manipulation of the results at the end of the day of someone who's an unknown. I mean, it's impressive that the vice president, no matter how good Binay is or Ram or Rojas, that a person who is not from the area is more popular. Unless they, hindi alam ko na, they hate Rojas in Leyte. Ganun labas
nun. Oh, no, yun ang masaklap ka.
Ay, hindi ba? Kung mali lang si Rojas, paano nanalo si Binay?
Yan ang mga...
Eh, bakit hindi nagsasalita ang mga tiga-Leyte? Ang mga tiga-Leyte, mahal nyo talaga po si Mayor Binay at si Mayor Binay, nagbibigay po ng pasas. Salamat sa inyo lahat! Kasi mahal na mahal kayo ni Mayor Binay. Pero si Rojas, masama ang loob niya kasi hindi nyo pala siya mahal. O yan, sakit pakinggan, ano? Pero ganun na nangyari. Ba't di magreklamo mga tiga-Leyte? Alam mo ba, di sila pwede magreklamo? Tumanggap din sila. Kaya huli rin eh, di ba?
Kaya nga, tumanggap sila because they are what you call the marginalized, economically marginalized part. And this is where the political factor sets in and controls the economic factor. Because they are treating those people who are selling or buying votes from this buyer, from these sellers, are saying, oh, sige na, pababayang. Anyway, I'm going to treat you well. And in effect, in reality, these actual politicians just want to treat those people like mushrooms.
Did GMA do well for Leyte in the last 9 years? Marami ba siyang ginawa para sa Leyte?
Yes, I would think
so. So, ba't kaya hindi nila binoto yung kandidato niya si Gibo?
I would think...
yung nga kini-question mo?
Mabigat talaga. Kasi nga yung... it depends siguro kung sinong nagdadala. Kasi sa amin, you know, this is my personal perception. No? Whoever is your mayor, your governor,
siya
your
magdidikta.
Yun ang gobyerno sa amin. Maswerte na kami kung makita namin si GMA na isang beses sa loob ng 6 na taon.
Ayun.
Tama
so,
naman.
Ang gobyerno namin, kung sinong nakaupo dyan.
Tama. Yes, local governors.
So, that is
local
it. Government. Like, yes. For example, a perfect example would be Ampatuan. Hmm. Yun ang gobyerno nila. Hmm. GMA is just as good as Obama. Hmm. Is a TV personality. Sa amin. Hmm. Ganun yun. Yun na yung, kaya, when, because I openly supported Noynoy and Mar. Mm-hmm. That's why I insisted that they come to my province because people were saying, hindi kami vote rich. What is 250,000? That's only 3 barangays in Quezon City. But I requested talaga, at pinakinggan naman ako, they went. Simply because, napakaliit namin. Kung hindi nga kami papansinin, na hindi pa nakaupo, ano ba pag
parang nangyari yun, nanalo si Binay.
Did Binay man?
I don't really, I cannot say for
kaya nga, alam na natin yung, ang problema, yung ginapa nga bago ang eleksyon eh. Miski mahal mo si Rojas, mas mahal ko 1,000.
No, si Rojas still made it in my province. Although in some municipality, malaking diferensya. Kung baga, kung si Edo nga, malaki ang vote sa amin eh. Dahil sa maot. Baka magulat ka pag sinabi ko sa yung 5% of his votes nationwide came from my province.
Are you saying that Obama is like a TV personality? Mm. President Obama is like a TV personality?
No, I mean yung perception ng tao is a...
Hanggang television
lang
sila.
Hanggang television na lang. Parang ganun ang nangyari sa amin. Dahil sa straight voting ng...
What are we going to do now, Marisa? You've been... you feel you've been cheated, yes, it seems. You have information, you have... you have evidence that you have, but it's a culture problem. What are you going to do now?
I think to say cheating is a very strong word because you cannot.
Some type of fraud because
yes,
of the buying.
Yes, there is some type of fraud.
Violation. What are you going to do now?
Because you are not free to. Yeah.
Lessons learned. Papasok ka ng governor, gobernador.
May lessons learned.
Maglalabas ka ng half a billion. Kung wala ka half a billion, magtatakbo. Down payment ka muna, di ba?
For me, I think what you should keep on doing is that if you're able to manage to keep like that 30 or 35% na hindi nayanig ng pera nila, then I think that's already one step. Mm-hmm. Diba, hindi ko naman in-expect na 100%.
Long evolutionary process.
Yeah, there's a flicker of a hope here.
There is the fact that meron nang nag-surrender, meron nang nag-ano.
That person can be considered a hero, a local hero.
Yun lang, as I've said, ako kasi pwede akong magligpit, umalis. Nandito na ako ngayon, bukas may trabaho na ako. Pero yung konsensya ko, yung mga taong naiwanan doon.
Hey, iwanan mo na. Iwanan mo na yung nabibili
yun
naman sila.
Yun ang ginawa ko, kaya masama
na. Tama yun. They deserve it. Marisa, gentlemen, we're going to have to end the show. But before we do, I'd like to give you a couple of minutes for you to wind up to give an exit message to our viewers. Mm. Whatever message you wish to tell them. Marisa, you first. Mm.
Well, for me, I'd like to thank you, Harry, Gil, and Robert for inviting me to your show today and for allowing me to express my views and my parting words to everyone who is listening. Kami na mga nasa countryside, kami pong nangailangan ng tulong. Mm. Kung meron kayong probinsya, maliit na lugar, uwiin ninyo doon at magtayo kayo na socio-civic oriented na grupo para magkaroon tayo ng tunay na pagbabago dahil doon mag-umpisang pagbabago sa mga lugar na hindi kasing modern ng Manila at Cebu at Davao. So kailangan namin ng tulong.
Thank you very much, Marisa. Robert Posadas?
Well, in terms of her experience and so far as her local experience is concerned, I think that isolated event that some of your people or your voters were disenfranchised, or they were attempted to be disenfranchised by vote buying. Okay, so that in itself is an evidence of cheating. Okay, so therefore, insofar as that election aspect is concerned or local aspect is concerned, there was really no credibility and honesty. So therefore, what you're trying to do is to manage your expectations, as you say, that you would like things to be considered as lessons to be learned for integrity. And so the same goes with the national elections. Generally, there's a perception of integrity because, after all, there were immediate results for the counting of the presidential votes and vice presidential votes, although they're still left hanging now until they are proclaimed by Congress. But there is a premise in which to base an analysis of whether the general election is honest and credible. And I still have to find that exact premise where to base it on. And as things develop, maybe we'll know more and more to whether to judge it in general, whether there has been a credible and honest elections.
Thank you very much. Gil?
Okay. Very, very short. What this amounts to really is poverty. And unless you have some economic activity in Southern Leyte, you will always have these marginalized people accepting every time there's an election some pieces of money, whatever the denomination, in exchange for their votes because they don't know any better. Mm-hmm. They must be able to see 1,000 peso bills as part of their monthly income, either from agriculture, correct, either from your offshore resources, fish, whatever it is, and they will be better. And they won't be, and then, kung may kabuhayan sila, hindi sila tatanggap ng pera dun sa politiko. At wala na magagawa yung politiko. Dahil sa yung mga tao, meron ng makakain, hindi na sila marginalized. No? At kung hindi na sila marginalized, hindi na sila pupunta sa party list. Hindi sumosobra yung party list, ano ha? Ganun lang yun eh. But, hindi tayo magkakaroon ng changes. We won't have the changes overnight. That you can be too sure.
In short,
you can cut off my hand if there's going to be any change overnight. Now, this is evolutionary. And the Filipino culture says, huwag ka nang mabahala. Dahil sa magkakaroon ng mga election, every 6 years naman yan eh. Pabayaan mo na sila, bahala na. Para, anong gagawin natin ngayon? Manonood tayo ng midnight.